sound, the name is table topic. What is it all about? Do we have to do something with the table or is it to do with the topic? Let me tell you, it's nothing to do with the table, but you have to use the topic which I'll give you to stand here and speak. And these topics will be very simple. Here you need to apply 3T, not the tension termination, but something little bit related to it. Now what are those 3T? First is think. Then, the moment I tell you the topic, tell yourself to come on stage. The third T talks about tell yourself to speak something on this topic. Basically, we do this table topic round is that so that you get a feel. It's impromptu speak. You get into a situation when you don't know what to speak. By participating in this table topic, you will be able to acquire many qualities, and if you fall into any kind of situation, you will be able to speak. So let me start this round. And the rule says, the moment I call one participant here, that person has to pick one set for the another person who is going to come on stage. Is the rule clear? Okay, for the first participant, I'll pick up the chit. And the first participant for this round is Mr. Chirag. The topic is okay, it's a very interesting topic. Imagine you are dating a girl. She saw a dirtiest bike she has ever seen in her life. Now, fortunately, that's your bike. How would you react and how will you drop her to a house?
Dear Toastmaster and guest judge, it has been since 10 years that I got married. It's difficult to actually get into the situation what the topic is. I think as normal people can do in those circumstances says that actually I am on Emmanuel biking race and I just came 2 days back and haven't got a chance to actually do a servicing of a bike, and then you can actually tell about all the stories what really happened actually during the Himalayan biking race of that expedition. And we can also relate the story about say when you were there, the horrible incident happened, the natural calamity happened in Ladakh, and you can actually relate those things. So I mean there are enough things you can actually go to you can convince your friends actually.
Good evening, Toastmasters. Good evening, friends. There are no stupid questions. There are only stupid people. I would like to say the questions are stupid, but the people are never stupid. People are always wise. Once when I was in a school, a teacher told us a joke. She said, a lady was asked to interview and speak to few guests. And she was given two questions to ask the guest. And the guests were, what is your name? Are you married? Do you have children? The lady said, fine. She asked her first guest, what is your name? Are you married? Do you have children? She became wise slowly. She said, why should I ask the same questions in the same order? She went, what is your name? Do you have children? Are you married? So this is an appropriate question. Those days I laughed at that question. But in today's context, it could be true. So that's what I would say. I would say the questions are stupid and people are not stupid. Thank you.
Next person on stage is Sujay. Topic is bad lucky day. It's a lucky day, but it's still bad.
Hello everyone. This is my first time. And after listening to some mind-blowing topics, I was actually reluctant to come and speak, but still I wanted to give a try. And as she says, bad lucky day. Can it be
anything?
I can say going out with a girl and having a nice time. And as you know, relationships have different complications at all. So you'll be talking about something and suddenly you say that, okay, the last girl I met had long hair. So then she starts up saying that, okay, after having a good day, and when you refer to that particular context, the lucky day is turned to when bad luck day. That's it.
To tell you the truth, the same thing I faced it. This is something in relation to it. Okay, the next person on stage is Robbie.
Evening everyone, this is my second time here. The most profitable mistake I would believe, if I go in the same context as my friend Sujay, if I tend to meet someone who is a bit more better looking than the previous one, and the previous one would have the same notion of saying that, yeah, this guy isn't so good, so she says, okay, I need to break up with you. Then I jump to the next wagon and I say, okay, fine, this is my profit. I get a much better deal out of the other non-deal. So I would say that would be a much more profitable mistake. A mistake because I know her much better, but the profit would be I would know this one much better because I learned the mistake from it. So thank you.
This would be when my mind would completely go blank and I would start to perspire. And then I'm trying to figure out the best way to avoid it. And the next thing that comes to my mind is, what's the worst that can happen? Let's as well admit the mistake. And I have a very popular phrase at that point of time, or cliche for me by now, is now is a good time to bite the bullet, face the music, because the more we tend to delay it or procrastinate about it, the volume would go more, become higher, and the bullet might as well become a missile. And then I usually fess up or I own up to that mistake and face the consequences as and when it comes. And that's the best I can do at that time. Thank you.
Next one. Naveen. As an alcoholic, you need cash for alcohol research. As an alcoholic, you need cash for alcohol research. I hope you understood the topic.
As an alcoholic, we need cash for alcohol research, but I don't know why an alcoholic has to do an alcoholic research. It has been done by Vijay Mallya. He has created so many brands. He's the second top producer of alcohol. I don't know about Vijay Mallya. He already has lots of money. He's doing all the research. My very sincere request to him is to continue the work, and I ensure him that I follow Mathukutty's step, the so-called Mathukutty's step of sipping, savoring and swirling the glass until I grab, gulp, gulp, gulp until I'm gone, making him richer, richer, richer. So my dear friends, apart from these things, alcohol is like a killer. So it harms your family, harms yourself. So my sincere advice to those alcoholics is, with responsibility on your shoulders, please quit alcohol unless it is a compulsion for you in a high-end meeting or something like that, where someone brings a wine to a presentation for everything. So in that cases, it's fine, a limit. So don't make yourself alcoholic and don't spoil your future. Madam, table topic sounds.